It's Tuesday. I'm in the toy box. I'm almost in the toy box. I got a loaded toy box. Let's do that. Let me know if this sounds okay. Because the levels were really low in XSplit, and so I cranked them up. And levels seem okay. Doesn't seem like I'm peaking, so. But we gotta go into toy box saves. We got a loaded toy box. Before it is officially Toy Box Tuesday. I believe V3 is where we ended off. Numerically, that would make sense. So here we go. This takes a while. What's up, Uzi Suicide? What's up? Holy Angel, what's up? Candy, what's up? Silent Consonant is going to be joining us, I'm assuming, in a couple seconds. He mentioned in chat that he's going to be on. It's Tuesday, everybody. How you doing? How was your weekend? I was in Seattle this weekend. I went to PAX. I like that a lot of the trips that I've taken recently haven't affected my participation in a lot of the stuff that we do. I unfortunately missed our group stream last week, but I will be back. I'm back. I'll be here tonight. But it's nice that PAX... Tuesday's a really nice day. It's nice that these events can kind of wrap themselves, even though PAX does go through Monday. I did not stay until Monday. I came home and Sunday night saw John Williams in concert at the Hollywood Bowl, which I was like, I love you, PAX, but see you later. Was that Brandon? Bowrider, yeah. I will send you an invite in just a second. Let me wait until this gargantuan, you know... bug inviting, just you know, massive beast that is the Easy Allies toy box. So hey everybody. So if you're just tuning in and you are unfamiliar with Toy Box Tuesday, this is Disney Infinity. It's a game that this has been canceled. I like to play it. I like to specifically build stuff. I will be wrapping up my time in 2016 with playing Disney Infinity every week. But before we do so, we gotta finish this toy box by September 30th. That is the cutoff, not for the servers of Disney Infinity, but for uploads. So for people to approve toy boxes that people make. Can't have the shenanigans. We need the shenanigans, though, every now and then, M-Bun. M-Bun's talking about, apparently, last Tuesday's stream went off the rails. I watched some of it before I got on the plane. And then, apparently while I was on the plane, stuff went down. So, because I landed... And I text Kyle and I'm like, you know, I'm probably not going to get there till like 9:45, maybe 10. I'm like, if you want to start the podcast before then, that's fine. I think it was like 8:45. And Kyle says, yeah, we just finished the stream. I'm like, you now? That was a 2-hour, 45-minute? Like, that rarely happens. I don't know why. I'm not really like a dictator. I mean, like, if anything, Damiani or Kyle really like manages the group streams a lot more than I do. But apparently when I'm not around... crazy stuff happens. Because that's happened before. Like, the first, I think it was in Florida, the first group stream that I did not attend, was extremely unhinged. I like to start out with the flying character. I got my boy Nova here. He's my favorite character in the game. I just love the way he animates. I love the way he flies. I love that all of his powers kind of stem from this, like, blue energy that just is in everything. It's in his projectiles. It's in, like, his, you know... attacks and whatnot. And his, I don't, he doesn't have any purple energy saved up, but he does a mean AoE attack. Blood and Jones are gone. We party late. Yeah, Blood was gone too. Maybe that's it. Maybe when Blood and Jones are gone. Okay. All right, we're ready. So let me send some invites. Again, the challenge here is always remembering to go back after I send out these invites. Oh wait, before I do that, hold on. I hate to switch to anything else because this score is so good. To The Incredibles. Incredibles 2. Trailer coming soon at some point. Whoops, flew too low. See, I underestimated Nova's strength. Step on that sucker. And that will change the environment every 30 seconds. So we can avoid, you know, possibly avoid some copyright protection issues on the music in this game. There's a lot of tracks that are from stuff. And to change it up so you're not listening as good as The Incredibles is. So you're not listening to that the entire time. So before I invite people, let's just take stock, okay? So when I invite people in, they can just jump right in. Here's where we are. and Jungle Book seems to be the win. I wonder if it's not in a random shuffle, but actually, like, goes through a list. but it almost always goes to Jungle Book on the second one. Not that I'm complaining. I like the shadowing there. That's really cool. So, your boy Jones jumped on the E here. We've had several people come in. I believe we had Bo Rider build either the A or the S, and Bo Rider's also working on the racetrack down below. Silent Consonant last stream jumped in on the A. I am currently building the Y. I need to finish the Y later. And we have one more user. I don't know, my phone is charging in the back. We have one more person. Maybe I should put that in like the description or something. That worked on the S. So we've had different allies jump in. Sounds like Bo Rider and Silent Consonant are in for the long run. If you have Disney Infinity 3.0 on PlayStation 4, Sid9 is my name up above. Just send me an invite. Tell me in chat you're online, and you can jump in anytime. So I'm assuming Bo Rider wants to finish the track. I'm assuming Silent Consonant wants to finish the A. I don't know how much more work he has to do on that. That's really cool. It's like a very... very platformy thing. He also, Silent, I have to compliment you before we get in there. I like your use of objects we have not yet used in this toy box. I think you like actively sought stuff that you were like, I don't think we've seen this kind of platform in this thing. So yeah, we definitely want to have surprises in this thing. Bo Rider, you're free to jump into either of the L's. I want to take the I and the S. I'm going to work on the S today, and if I finish the S before the end of the stream, I'm going to work on the I. No idea what to do with the E. The L would be kind of fun if they were mirrored in some way, or if there was some kind of theme that, because it's the only two, we got two E's in this, we got two A's, and we got two S's. There's actually a lot of repeated letters in this, this phrase that we've created, but the L's are the only two that are right next to each other, so we should probably do something. They're kind of like really simply shaped, so it'd be maybe cool to like turn the L's into buildings, to put like building, fronts or something along the side. Maybe something that you can't see, like, from above. But, I digress. So yeah, let me fly over to the S here. Yoink. And, again, looks much different when you get down into it. Cool. Let's invite some peeps. Hey, everybody. Yeah, Toshi, you say it officially. I'm taking the I and the S. I claim them right now. Because stuff can get really unruly in the toy box, you know? People can, always do that. I want to go to online multiplayer. We had crashes last week. We definitely had crashes. We've had crashes before on Toy Box Tuesday, but we had like three last week. Or, yeah, last week? Yes, no, 2 weeks ago. Also, sorry I didn't do one last week. But, I got to fly up to San Francisco, and I got to be on a Batman show for Telltale Games. So, couldn't pass that up. Hold on. Mickey and Wreck-It Ralph and Sam Flynn are playing right now. So that is all my friends online. Just one person. I believe that is Silent Consonant. Is ready to go. Bo Rider will probably come in a little bit later. But invite sent to Mr. Silent Consonant. I remembered to come back immediately. Okay. So... like the music. So what I want to do with the S, so here, I'll show you the inspiration for the S. Do-do-do, what's up, Kaylee? Is it afternoon yet? 10 a.m. where I am. So this is a kind of silly entrance thing. I might, like, touch up the E a little bit more. I probably will not have time. A is kind of a little platform tribute. We'll probably add a couple other platform traps, maybe some invisible stuff. S is a nice little garden tour. Maybe we'll get the environment to change and drop a little more light in here. But I can't remember if it was Bo Rider, came in and built the garden. Bo Rider's probably corrected me, and I totally missed it in chat, sorry. Whoever made the garden initially put these flower things on right in the middle, and I moved them to the side, put a little grass underneath, so it's actually something you can walk through. And we have little tiny, like, decorative trees in here. And I think there were some stuff like this. I might actually change this. I might actually make this something different. Just a different style. Because I think one of the things that I removed from here was there were a lot of trees, and I kind of like this being like a little botanical area. Maybe like have some, actually yeah, we should have like some little plants up here. Like go through like the plants section and try to create like a nice arrangement. We do have a little secret thing in here. Oh, totally was Bo Rider because this goes down to the racetrack, which is hilarious, which I never really thought of because the racetrack and the garden here have absolutely nothing to do with each other. It's the racetrack garden. This is Bo Rider's. contribution. And we'll add some stuff later. Again, we'll just go through all of the decorative plants. But as far as, like, trees are concerned, we don't have a lot of trees. So what I want to do, I want to bonk my head, and I want to fly over here. Yeah, R. Haley, there's a lot of lightsaber swinging at a John Williams live concert, so you gotta be careful, man. You don't know who behind you is. I don't think those are all trained Jedi that are wielding those lightsabers. It's dangerous. Not hearing from Silent Consonant. I wonder if there's an issue. Gonna tighten up that A a bit, fix the top of the L, maybe expand into the L? Sure. I just, whatever we do with the L, I want to, I just want to mirror it, or try to, with the other L. So it'd be cool if, like, one was, like, the dark version, the first L was, like, the light version of whatever you did, and then it's, like, the dark version and the other L. Actually, I'm pointing to it. There we go. John Williams' mosh pit would be awesome. My two favorite moments from, John Williams in concert. He played... Actually, this will be a fun... this will be a fun game to play with chat. Hopefully, all of you know who John Williams is. He is a very famous composer. What's the best thing John Williams has ever written? Not the movie, the track. The actual track of a John Williams score. What is the best single track that that man has ever written in his... Like, I think the guy's been making music since the 50s, so that's like... almost 70 years that he's been doing music, and he's going to write the music for episode 8, so like he's still making Star Wars. If that man survives for another couple years, he will have written music for every single Star Wars main episodic film. That's insane. Next to Anthony Daniels, he's like the Peter Mayhew, but I don't, Peter Mayhew wasn't in episode 1. I think he's the only, Anthony Daniels and John Williams, correct me if I'm wrong, are the only artists to have been involved with every single Star Wars film. In the same role. Basically being like, this is who I am in this movie. Duel of Fates, okay. The music in 7 is awful. Oh, breaking my heart. He played Ray's theme. Ray's theme is really great. I think maybe... one thing to consider is like, his music for episode 1 was really good. It's edited into the film very poorly. Duel of the Fates is actually kind of butchered in the movie. Like, it's not... The Duel of the Fates in, actually, Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, is not the Duel of the Fates you can get on an album. The Duel of the Fates on an album is, like, a piece of music that he wrote. And because you're just, like, bouncing back and forth between, like, the Gungan planet and the, you know, Trade Federation ships and, like, you know, the Gungan planet, Naboo, but you're, like... You know, like, now you're with, you know, like, Ewan McGregor and, you know, Liam Neeson, and then it's, like, Anakin flying around. And I think they jumbled that a lot. I think they were struggling a lot with the pacing of that sequence. And so I think they just kind of, like, took a hacksaw to his score. But, Duel of the Fates is good. It's one of the, yeah, it's one of, like, the throne room's fantastic. E.T. theme is pretty good. Harry Potter's theme song, otherwise known as Hedwig's theme. Bow Riders Online, okay, sorry. Duel of Fates, only answer, lots of Duel of Fates. Okay, Jurassic Park, so I'm guessing the main theme from Jurassic Park. Jaws theme is real good. Okay, the prequel for the Star Wars, okay. So if you don't know who John Williams is, he is the single most prolific film composer of all time. True fact, I know this will sound like Huber hyperbole. I love that they're white now, that's great. Actually, thanks, I need that. I need them to be plain white like that, that's good. Thank you to whoever set the theme. John Williams is my favorite living artist. John Williams is my favorite human being alive today creating art in any medium. Whether that's book writing, or acting, or direction, or comic book illustration, or... YouTube creation, anything. Like, I think literally all of us, like, you know, love and respect to all of you, but we are all just chumps compared to that man. Like, I think people throw the word genius around a lot. I think John Williams is a genius. There you go. That's it for my General Williams. Because that man, you know, one of the biggest compliments that I ever receive from people, speaking of, went to PAX this weekend, saw a lot of fans. Thank you for everybody that said hi. When people say, hey, thank you for game trailers, I grew up with you. Like, I grew up with game trailers. And that's incredible. That's like a, it's a, you know, it's humbling. It's also terrifying because it makes me feel old. But like, I grew up with John Williams. John Williams is my childhood. Like when I relived E.T. and Indiana Jones, like a lot of times I didn't watch the movie. I just listened to the score again and again and again. Like I grew up loving Guns N' Roses and Pearl Jam and Nirvana and all these bands, but like I didn't own their albums. I bought soundtracks. I bought like film soundtracks. And never missed a chance. Begged, pleaded with my parents always to get tickets to see him at the Bowl whenever he played. So, and I missed him a couple times because I was in school. I missed him a couple times, like college, like when I went out of town, and missed him a couple times just in the GT years because of PAX. Like I would, you know, be at PAX or be at some stupid event. But yeah, 86 years old, I think. So, yeah, definitely man crush, PP. So lots of really yeah, Danny Elfman's also amazing, voice of Jack Skellington. So lots of really good comments, lots of good suggestions. Unfortunately, all of you are incorrect. You know, I like to be really open about people's opinions and their interests here at Easy Allies, especially on Toy Box Tuesday. You know, this is the land of creativity, but y'all are wrong. The correct answer to the best John Williams track ever created is the Empire March from The Empire Strikes Back. That is the best thing that he has ever written, and he played it, which is why I brought it up. But come on, you got episode 4. You go through episode 4, all of that stuff. You have the destruction of the Death Star. You have, you know, the theme of the Force when, like, he's talking about that. You have Luke's theme. You have the opening scroll, which was way better than George Lucas could have possibly deserved, you know, to like, you know, to show this movie. You have the throne room scene. You have the end credits. Like, there's so many amazing, not throne room, but the award ceremony at the end, the medal ceremony. You have all these amazing tracks. And what a lot of people forget is that, like, the Empire March, dun, 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 is not in that movie anywhere. Even close, not even, like, hinted at. The first time you hear that is in The Empire Strikes Back when the Empire shows up to just destroy the Echo Base. And that's, like, he just totally owns that entire scene. Like, that, So, played it. And the thing that's great is everybody brings lightsabers to the concert. And so everybody's done. And it's just seeing like an, you know, being under the stars and seeing like a huge auditorium of a bunch of nerds, many of who are like 30 years or older. So yeah, there you go. Respect, love and respect for all your opinions. I like seeing Jurassic Park in there. I like seeing E.T. in there. He played E.T. actually. A lot of people forget about E.T. I'm so glad they haven't remade that or something, knock on wood. Yeah, played a lot of good stuff. How are we doing? So I'm making a new ceiling here, basically. I'm gonna delete these blocks up above when we're done. I just have them there for reference. But, making a ceiling. And then, underneath I'm gonna put a little forest. A cute little forest. And then I'm gonna look at that forest from above, and, oh, I'm gonna invite Bo Rider too. Sorry. I got all wrapped up in my love of John Williams. Actually, let me do that now. I'll pause, and I will invite Bo Rider, and I will save it. But y'all are entitled to your own opinions, you know. I just feel strongly. I'm channeling my inner Bob Ross. Happy trees. I want to invite a friend. I want to invite any and all friends playing Disney Infinita. Right, meow. Cool. I'm getting it. I'm getting better at it. Episode 7 is diplomatic. That's a very interesting one-word review. What I'm hoping, the Star Wars fan in me is hoping that Episode 7 was like Arnold Palmer walking up and placing the tee, like, into the ground. You know, basically being like, okay, this is Rey, This is Kylo. This is the Resistance. They're not the Rebellion. Remember that. Commit to that. So when we throw the word Resistance at you, you know what we're talking about. Here's Snoke. Here's, you know, like, here are these people, love them or hate them. Here's BB-8, you know, like, here's Maz. Like, I don't know if we're getting more Maz Kanata in Episode 8. And then Episode 8, it's like Spider-Man 2. Just starts and just leaves the station and is just a roller coaster of emotions. Just like all, you know. I mean, spoilers. I mean, by this point, we should all know. You should have all seen Episode 7. I'm not going to forget about it. I mean, like, I'm not going to talk about, like, scene description and stuff like that. But, like, spoilers, Han Solo dies in Episode 7. Like, it's very clear to me that Harrison Ford was like, okay, I'll do one of them. You know, like, I'll come back. But, like, I don't know, you know. JJ, I don't know if I got it in me to do, like, a whole series. So, you know, get that out of the way. You know, like, get, you know, say goodbye to the characters we need to say goodbye to. Create a little drama with R2-D2 if you want, but, like, everybody's back. Like, we're all reunited, old and new. We got two full movies to just, you know, kick ass. I'm so excited. I have hope. And if that movie was A New Hope, for sure. And I messed this up somehow. Yeah, yep. Goof that up real good. So we want to mirror the top part to how many... Where is that? Oh boy. Maybe there. Maybe one more? Yeah, there might be one more. Okay. Oh yeah, it's canon that he wanted to die in Episode 5. And it's canon that Lando was supposed to die in Episode 6. Which I kind of have always preferred. You know, I mean, think about, like, Episode 7, man. He went, you know, like, Han Solo went down like a champ. I'll defend that scene. That scene is really, really well done. That film is, you know, it's kind of like Watchmen for me. Like, Watchmen is flawed, for sure. But that comic book, I remember, like, even in high school, talking about Watchmen the movie. And being like, yeah, Watchmen movie. How the hell would you do that? Like, I couldn't even think. Like, I was adapting, like, Killing Joke and Batman Year One into screenplays. Like, I was obsessed with, like, how do you update something? Like, how do you do, like, when people were like, oh, Smurfs movie? It's like, hell yeah, Smurfs movie. Let's do this. Like, it would be really cool. Like, it could be cool. He-Man movie? Like, you know, She-Ra movie? Like, Aquaman movie? Like, it's possible. Even then, I was like, oof, Watchmen. That's a TV show. Netflix really should pick up Watchmen and do, like, a 10-part Watchmen. Then you could do it. Like, then you wouldn't have to, like, not do stuff. But it's like, boy, you only got 2 hours and 30 minutes, maybe? Maybe 2:15? Like, that's just not Watchmen. That's just... will never be what Watchmen's about. You have to live in that world. Like, you can't, you know... You can't live in a world for that amount of time. We got Bo Rider in? Oh, wait. Yeah. I invited Bo Rider. Like, did I dream that I invited Bo Rider? Claxington, I love Disney Infinity 2. Breaks my heart. I went to PAX this weekend, and it's like, no Disney. One of my favorite musicals? I really like Sondheim. I know that's like a, you know, it's like, of course, like, I like Sondheim, I like musicals. But like, the guy, Sondheim's like the John Williams of the musical world. The guy is a staggering talent. I just want to make sure Bo Rider's... coming in. Weird. I'll check in a bit. So we just want to put some happy little trees in here. Favorite musicals? Sweeney Todd. I really like Assassins. It's very controversial musical. But if any of you just want a trip, read about or look up Assassins. Assassins the musical. I was in Assassins in college. Guys and Dolls is always I love noir. I love, like, I love that era. Guys and Dolls is just a really sexy show. Guys and Dolls is fun, too, because it reminds me of Pirates of Penzance, which is also another one of my favorite shows, in that Pirates of Penzance is funny because it sounds like a modern show. Like, we're not a modern show, but, like, it sounds like a show written in, like, you know, the 70s. Or, you know, like, a show that knows how subversive it is. But it's a very old show. The rights are out on that show. You can do Pirates and you don't have to pay anybody. And Guys and Dolls is kind of like that, too, in that you can interpret the source material in a billion different ways. So I've seen versions of Guys and Dolls that have made jokes out of scenes I didn't even know jokes were there. It was like, oh, you can totally make that scene funny. But I think Pippin might be my favorite musical. Pippin's also really good. Pippin is a Bob Fosse classic. And Stephen Schwartz co-wrote Pippin. And Stephen Schwartz also wrote a bunch of Disney movies. I think he wrote Little Mermaid and or Beauty and the Beast or all of them. But growing up, I was a huge Les Mis and Phantom of the Opera fan, but they're kind of bubblegum. No offense to Andrew Lloyd Webber. Loved Phantom when I was a kid, though, man. Musical about a ghost that kills people? Yes, please. Music's a little hot on the television. Gotta focus. Trees. Plants. There we go. Sorry. Oh, so that fits. That's cool. So let me put that. So I want to put these on the back so that when you're looking at this thing at an angle, you don't see them. You might see that, though. Yeah, don't put that one in. So, like, back here. Yeah. Oops. No. Yep. No. And if we need to, we've started to we've started to cheat a little bit. We've like added these blocks so like you can't see what's going on inside of the A. But you can't really tell when you get up there because that's the end of the toy box up above. You go up above so you can take a gander at it. So I might do that in here in the middle of the S, but it's kind of fun to take the shape of the S and kind of mold the trees in that. Let's do that. Nope. Swing and a miss. Yeah, let's do that. Let's go around here. See, so you gotta like walk around. Or you don't have to, because you can like jump through the trees. Maybe I can put invisible walls on the other side. Or maybe. Or maybe this is, like, the last gem. Maybe we could put a gem at the end of this. And there actually is invisible walls, and you gotta, like, get to the end. We can do that. Because we have little gems, and then when you get all the gems, then you open up, a little secret. Otherwise known as, a little trip to the garage. Which I am, also building separately, which I streamed the first creation of, but... I'm still working on. Boy, this toy box is getting dangerously full. You'd have to go through here. Yeah, you'd have to, like... You'd have to have the entrance, like, here. Oh, there. Tricky. I wonder if... Okay, no, I'm gonna... No. Change this whole thing. Not the whole thing. Talk amongst yourselves. Once I lay down the base structure for this, I'll fly around so you can get a gander at what everybody else has been working on. Kill you. Kill you guys. Okay. So, I'm gonna put a little, like, pre-forest area down here. And then over here will be hugging the inside of the letter. Yeah. So we'll be just like a little hallway. So you can, and maybe I might put up invisible walls or something, so you can't just like hop right into it. So yeah, you'll have to like come around the side there. So actually, should I have things? So it's tempting. No, wait. Yeah, back into here. So it's tempting when you get to the end here, that you're like, oh, the teleporter, I made it. I want to jump in there. And it's like, wait, no, go back. And I might put, like, some trees up in front here, so you have to, like, go through here. And then maybe something happens. There's something, but you got to go all the way to the back here and doop, get an item. Maybe I'll, like, make a little enclosure here, like a little house, a little hut or something, and it's inside. But before we do that, let's take a gander at what everybody else is doing. Is this Wreck-It Ralph? Yes, it is. We are inside an arcade machine. This is what it looks like. We got Silent Consonant here, working on the A. Thor's lending a helping hand. But see, he's got like, he's using all sorts of cool stuff that we didn't use. We got clouds, got, yeah.
Haven't seen you in a while, Thor.
See, called Thor out. I was playing, you know, I don't try not to overuse my mentions of LEGO Dimensions when, my mentions of LEGO Dimensions. Oh boy, this is getting out of control. Last time I was playing LEGO Dimensions, and I had Bart Simpson and Batman on at the same time, and Batman said, could this be the elusive Bartman? Probably not. I was like, points! Points for thinking of something for Batman to say to Bart Simpson. Points. Brush is down, gentlemen, just for a second. I'm gonna save this puppy. So we don't lose the awesome work that we've done so far. Brush is down. If you want to do extra credit, meet me at the top. Meet me on top of the A, the usual meetup place. It's always good to play somebody who's flying. You can just like that move. We'll walk him back. Year 2 starting September 28th. Year 2. What's up, Thor? Is he coming? There he is. Yay! Oh, he's both that nice. We're all flyers. I love it. 2 Marvel flyers, 1 Star Wars flyer. Yeah, let's save it over V3. Yep. Cheers to you, V3. Mark Hamill and Kevin Conroy teased Hush and A Death in the Family, DC animated films.
Nobody can handle.
Excellent, we're done. Go for it. Whee! This racetrack, man. Just like add details to it, but don't. That's a very long racetrack. I'm just nervous. Maybe somebody knows. I don't know if anybody specifically from gets very technical with Disney with the Infinity, but like we're going into the red with those top things, but I don't know. I guess the middle with the body, that's like AI. I don't know. Like, maybe I can look them up. I really wanted to. Really quick. I don't know what you would call those, like load images, like. Toy box size icons. I don't know what you would call those. I just want to know, like, when are we going to get in trouble? Because some of that's in the green. Some of that's fine. But I don't know if the top part is really what we need to worry about. Because I know that the more you put different stuff into a toy box, the more it freaks out. I know the easiest way to crash a toy box is enemies. And so what I want to do in the toy box is have a lot of things that spawn enemies, but not necessarily have enemies present in the toy box when you load it. so that it doesn't like have a heart attack trying to like spawn all these things at once. There we go. How does the toy box meter work? Graphical memory, system memory are the two. So here we go. So the two things that are pushing into the red indicates how much graphical memory is being used, affected by a large number of different items in the toy box, mostly detailed buildings and toys with moving parts. When this fills up, you can only place more of the same items that are already in the toy box. Okay. System memory indicates how full the toy box is. Won't generally fill up before a different gauge stops you from building. So yeah. That guy in the bottom, in the yellow, is just your general size of the toy box. And that is in the yellow. It is the bottom one that is in the yellow. And it's not like, you know, rapidly approaching the red. But let's all just remember. And keep in mind, if it comes down to crunch time, I might just dump some stuff. Not entirely, but make things a little less substantial, make them a little smaller. Self. Okay. So let's. Yeah, let's do some more. How are we gonna do this? Get over there. Okay, so there should be... Entrance should be, like, here. Be tricky to get to. Should be on the, like, opposite corner of where you want to be. So. And then, let's put one there. Yeah, maybe I'll cover up the S here, but I won't cover up the S on the top, so you get like a little sunroof, so when you're in there, you can look up. So yeah. So got all these trees. We can change the style of them. Lost Empire Pillar, San Francisco tree, Dunbro tree. What does that look like? It sticks through the top, nice. It's actually kind of, I was curious about that. So when we put that in place, I was like, oh, they're that tall. I guess all the different styles conform to that space. But this is a really fascinating way to make the game clip through something. Which I don't know if you can do. Yeah, some of these are, you know, really big. Yeah, look at that. That one perfectly fits underneath. But a lot of these don't. Disney Dragon Terrain. I kind of like that. So I'm actually going to... I'm actually going to change a couple of them and then take a look and see which one I like. Death Star terrain, yeah, always nice, but no. Fun to look at though. Endor terrain looks kind of tiny. Hoth terrain, nice. Nice, very good. Nope. Ooh, Jungle Ruin statue though. I should put that over by the entrance because I have kind of a... Wait a minute. Did that actually just, like, get deleted? The thing? Oh, great. Never mind. Yeah, some of these are just not gonna work. Okay. Sure. Okay, this thing's kind of cool, and it's very, yeah, I'm gonna do that, Toy Story terrain. Because it's very, like, obtrusive, like, you can't, like, I can get through here, but I don't know if I put two of these right next to each other if you can actually walk through that. Or if you couldn't, it looks like it would make sense. It's like, yeah, that would probably block me right there. The game designers probably don't want me to go right there. That's probably not, like, the place I'm supposed to go. So if I put, like, an invisible wall on the back here, the user wouldn't be like, what? I have some PSN codes for games and stuff. Is it okay if I give them out via the EZA Twitch stream? Yeah, I would defer actually to Daniel Bloodworth or Michael Damiani on how they want to handle that, because they've been doing codes in the past. So just as far as like timing, so reach out to if you want to do that. I maybe test that tonight, Zandeus, and in the half an hour, 20 minutes before the stream, when Damiani's on the computer and messing around with music and stuff like that. Just check in with them and be like, hey, I got codes. What's the best way to give these out? But, thanks. No, I don't want to do that. No. Back up. Whoops. See, you can't put that down. That's cool. You can change the style when it's next to each other. Can you put two of these next to each other? No, you can't. I can't even... That thing, like, shouldn't even exist. The game rejected that. Okay, fine. I'll move this over here. I'll turn this into that. Just so I can look at it. And I'll change the style of this. Okay. Tron Monolith is cool. Iceland terrain is too big. Too big. Oh, I think we're done. How tall is that? Cool. I was wondering if that... Is that too tall? Let's see. I'm going to find out. Please don't be too tall. Oh, sweet. Yeah, this thing's kind of cool. Let's like... Yeah. Let's do... Let's put a couple of you down. Or just one. Fine. And let's... Give it a spark mode. Let's put you like here. Let's do. Okay, sorry, just thinking this through. Oh yeah, we'll do. Okay, yeah, we'll do that. Get you. Oh, hi, everybody. I forgot you were all here. Spent so much time enjoying this toy box. Oops. Messed that up. There we go. Not the Asgard pillar. The Lost Empire pillar. What is the Lost Empire? Is that Atlantis? So yeah, these guys are cool. Maybe I'll put these on the inside, but I kind of like the, I'll put that in there to remember it. But I kind of like these guys. So I'm going to... Delete all y'all. Sneeze first. Lots of fun building games coming up. Played the demo again. I believe it's like the fourth time I've played it, of Dragon Quest Builders. Very excited for that to come out. That comes out in a month. Dreams supposedly comes out in 2016. I don't know if I was smoking crack when I thought that. Like... I don't know if I'm just, like, very, very wrong.
So I need to... Nope, so put you down there. And then... Theme you. Go back. Is Retro Train too big? Oh, that's unfortunate, because that's awesome. All the coolest trees are really tall. Not fantasy. Disney there. So then, yeah, I'm going to set the theme. There we go. Okay. Maybe I'll just make this like a hallway. You just can't get to it from the outside. Or it'll, like, at least just, like, kind of like hug the outside of the S. Give it a warm little hug. You know, these are happy hugging trees. These trees don't want any war. These trees just want to be loved. So yeah, you can like jump right through if you want, but I'm gonna put some invisible walls up in there. I wonder if there's anything else like decoration wise. Tree is just so cool. I wonder if you can put this. Okay, so where did this go? How many of these trees can we put in? Not many. I swear if there's something. Oh wait, what am I talking about? Yeah, there totally is. So there's these guys. These are cool. So you have like what to theme you, and this camera angle is probably going to be terrible for looking at it. I guess not. Wait, whoops. Yeah, I'm just going to like... Yeah, I'm just going to move you out here real quick. Get a sense how big you are. Whether if this just getting to work at all. So yeah, put that under that. I'm also thinking too that what we can do obviously is... When you approach a letter, instead of having to stick to this terrain and have that dictate how tall the letter is, you can also just go down. That might be interesting to do maybe with the I. Like, you drop into the I and you expect it to be like, oh, it's just going to be about that long. And it's actually like a really far drop. That might be fun. But we need to figure out what style we're going to use for this. Excuse me. Still just so tall. It's interesting that that one thing is a light, and that... And that, like, a lot of these aren't lights. That's pretty sweet, though. There's the dragon terrain. I guess it's just a different kind of tree. Death Star... That's the Death Star terrain. Okay. Endor looks extremely tall. Palms now. No man is an island. No. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Ooh! I kind of like that. That's whimsical. Run Halo, it's in. Okay. Oh, and I believe... Whoa. Yeah, Richard Gamtree. What? What? You want to come up and you want to say hi to everybody, Sophie? Sophie's like, it's fun hanging out with you, but you hang out with in here for 2 hours. It's like, please, it's a nice day outside. Why can't we open the door? Because ambulances and helicopters go by. It makes a lot of noise. I'm sorry, Soph.
How do you tell that to a dog?
How do you explain to a dog?
There might be a couple hundred people watching this right now, Sophie. Oops, I'm sorry, my phone is bugging. Was that enough?
Apparently that was enough. I like the little Pixie Hollow thing. Yeah. A hanging lily, which will undoubtedly not fit. Yeah, that looks pretty cliptastic right there. Whoa, that's not what I meant to select at all. Yeah, you don't fit under there. There's no way you fit under there. That's unfortunate. Okay. Right. Whoop. Well, no. Too tall. YT statue. No. Tatooine terrain. Like a perfect circle around it. Too big. Bummer. Is that... So the smaller thing is taller than the wider thing in that one style? That's weird. The palms probably looks like it doesn't fit. Bummer. A lot of these kind of suck. Okay, I guess we'll do this little light thing. Classic Fantasyland terrain. I just like having a little light there. Just tuck that in the corner there. So I'm going to put that there, and then what I want to have is, like, something that blocks... It looks like all of these are just so insanely massive. So, okay, Fantasyland terrain is the different kind of styles that we want. But I just want something that visually obscures this area a little bit more. Because you can basically see through it. So I just want to, like, not be able to totally see through it. Maybe we can just go through the actual tree list. Maybe find some. Whoa, that is a gigantic tree. Because, like, the big things aren't necessarily, like, thin. You know, they're, like... Just like the huge and wide, and they take up so much space, and they're big on the top and small on the bottom, and so, you know, they're actually not doing the job, not cutting the mustard. Door topiary isn't terrible, you know, just kind of further obscures your view, but you can still kind of see through it. Bullseye. Yeah, plant selection, tree selection. Sorry, not the most like thrilling thing today. On this Toy Box Tuesday, we're getting down on the wire. We got to do the dirty work. Yeah, I'm going to try the strip here. I'm going to try one of these and see if I can find... I'm just going to move it up top here so I can get a good view of it. Let's see if I can find a super small one that I like. Here, and I'll lay in the second strip down here too. So it's got these super tall trees on it. It's like, calm down. Oops, wait. Okay, there we go. Okay. Let's do this. Through the looking glass. It's not bad. It's not very busy. Lost Empire now. It's kind of fun. Is it a bus stop? Monolith's too tall. Yeah, too tall. Construction strip. There's the dragon terrain. That might actually fit. Yeah, that would go theme-wise. That would make sense. So this one, yeah, the dragon's pretty nice. Yeah, probably too tall. See, thing is probably too tall, and it's like totally void in the middle. Okay, so let's get back to the dragon thing's kind of fun. And the dragon thing, I think, was a hotel like magic band pass thing. I think that like has a dragon terrain like background and stuff. Damn, it doesn't fit. Oh man, brutal. You just make the S taller, but it's like just like that they're sized that way. Well, there's always this guy. Little John Williams for you. Is there no dragon thing here? Disney Dragon Terrain Strip 2. No, that's not very complex, and it looks like it's even taller than the other one. Whoa! Yeah, that guy's a little tall. Okay, maybe we're going about this all wrong. Let's see if we can find, like, decorations or something that... Because I'm trying... Whoops, wait, no. I want to delete you. Get out of here. You're fired! Alright. Maybe have, like, another enemy spawn back here and have this be a red gem. Maybe put, like, an item here that people can use. Gotta block this off. So we drop some decorations down, and then we'll save this thing. Well, let me look for decorations and cross my fingers. Just go buy them. Decorations. The decorations of the plant variety. We are an hour in. Yeah, these stone. Okay. The medium stone. I guess I could alternate it. So that you gotta look through both. That's one option. We got a log, you know. It's kind of fun, actually, to put two logs on top of each other, although that would probably look really dumb. But... kind of like the log. Yeah, I'm going to put the log there. Let's see if putting two logs actually does look super stupid. Yes, it does. Just making sure. You can, like, you know, jump up and over if you want, but there'll be an invisible wall, so you can't. My God. Anything else that's foresty? Really. Stacked boxes? Yeah, so much. Hay bale? Yeah, small fence. Ah, it's about really doesn't fit. I guess I can move those trees just a little bit to either side. So it would be fun if you, like, blocked it off. People are like, what? And then they could, like, smash to get in there. They're just like, what? Get out of here. It would be kind of fun. This will add some visual interest a little bit, just to, like, just move these guys out of the way just a little bit. I have everything so perfectly lined up. Back in. Oh, perfect. Okay. That meter on the right is getting scary.
Froggy with fries. Thanks, man. Thank you for tuning in. Man or woman. Dude or dudette. I'm looking for plants. Thank you for joining me in my search for forest hiding plants. Puppet Theater's gotta go somewhere. Somewhere in this toy box. It's the thing, I wanna decorate it, I wanna add more stuff, we're just running out of space, everybody. Ooh. I just don't like the color, but these aren't terrible. Too bad you can't, like, just slide them in the middle there. Kind of cool, though. Isn't that interesting? This is a weird, this is my weird little forest. Just give me, you know, just let me have my weird little forest. White crayon, sure. Why is there only one color and why is it white? I don't know. Coral is, I draw the line of coral. We're not doing you coral. Sorry. Well, there's a lot of it. Okay, there we go. We're down to the end of these, and then we had these, like, stone pillars, and we're gonna add those. There we go. Medium, I believe, was the correct size. So don't line them up with the trees, but put them in the middle. That fits. I'm gonna put so you have to find something in here. And I guess I can put it. I guess it's kind of fine to put it at the end here. Kind of want to like make that area just a little more interesting. I wonder if there's like a rock I can put in there or something. Get out of here. Here that you're way into the Neo beta. Any personal hitake for us? Shanghai does have a Disneyland. It opened in July. Thanks for bringing up that sore subject. Any advice for first visits to Cali Disney? Yeah, here at Froggy, I'll let chat fill that in. Yeah, Neo's pretty sweet. I'm currently stuck on, like, the boss at the end of the tunnel area, which is one of the new areas that they added. There's a little cave tunnel that you go through. That area is currently whooping my ass. I love Neo. I love the speed of it. I love how fast the character runs. I love actually fighting people instead of monsters for a change, although fighting monsters is fun too. But I like, the enemies are just very aggressive, and I like, I super dig it. I don't want to go on and on about a very violent game during Toy Box Tuesday, but I enjoy it. What was I doing? I want to find. We just went through decorations. They didn't have. Let's go back. Take it back, everybody. Let's do this. Let's do this guy again. Let's see if there's just one last. Actually, do want something like this, like a yeah. Actually, yeah, that's pretty cool. I wonder if the orb would fit above the altar. And it'd be fun if people missed, like, all the orbs and then saw this one orb at the end and it was like, you got one orb of 9. And they were like, what? Like, oops. I guess I'll go back and get the other ones. Gameplay toys. There we go. Where's that orb at? Red gem, excuse me. No orb. Yeah, look at that. Oh, that's awesome. Yes. Oops. Oh well. Put that again later. Yeah. So you can see it from the outside too. So when you're going by, it's like, oh, I want to get. Oh, how do I get that? I want to get that one. You can't. Gotta go in. And probably when you get to like here-ish, some of the Dunbro guys will pop up and you gotta beat them up. And then get in there, get that last gem. Boop. Or you know what we could do? Or we could do this. I wonder if like a wall fit in here. Probably not. But we could try. Nope. Let's move this over here. And move you over on top of it. And let's get an actual wall. Short block wall. Yay? Yay. Okay. Okay, so this is always so frustrating when the stuff doesn't fit. That doesn't fit there. That goes up against that tree, and that's too much there, but that doesn't fit there. So, I'm gonna select this guy. And no, wait. Does that fit there? No, that doesn't fit there, so we can't do it. I guess I can put it on the back side. I guess we can do it. Let's see if we can cheat it. Hold on a second. It's tricky. I guess that's not terrible. Just adds a little more pizzazz. Let me see if I can. Nope. Nope, definitely don't select that. See if I can push you back again. Nope, you collided into that now. Okay. Cool. This makes it a little harder to see. And then we can just make these castle or something, or dungeon. Sure, here we go. Cool. Feels like a time to save. So if you can hear me, gentlemen, please join me at the top of the A. Let's save this sucker. Can't believe it. No crash. Knock on wood. No, that was just me knocking on wood, so...
Superheroes just smack each other around into the room.
Hi, Sawubi. What's up, everybody? We got Thor and everybody's over here? Nice. No, not a new save. P3. Save it. Do it! The white A is for loading and unloading only. All right, there we go. Back to work. So even though you can't see it there now, you can see the space where it is going to be, so it will return every time you reload the toy box. And then I will assign each of those orbs. Thanks, Candy Coat of Thorns. So yeah, so you got this little closed off forest area here. You're gonna be like, why do I gotta go through here? And just so I don't forget, let me add back to decorations. Decorations. There we go. Sophie plushie. Yeah, we should definitely do that. Eventually, that would be hilarious. I wonder if there's a Portillo plushie. I would totally buy one. Have your own little Portillo. Give me that fence. Where's that fence? There it is. That is a tall fence. So, cool. It's like off limits, but you're like, ha ha. And then, well, first of all, let me see. Ooh, actually, I don't want to go up too high. That's where it crashed last time. But it's like kind of obscured. I'm trying to think what, It's cool that you can see the shadow. You consider a reward tier for Patreon that involves a monthly hike with you and Amanda and Sophie, or some combination of the three. We can't do, like, location-specific Patreon rewards. I guess people can sign up if they know they live in L.A. and they want to go hiking with us, but, yeah, meeting fans is fun. Meeting fans and then immediately going deep into the woods sounds like a horror movie, but it's food for thought. I didn't see news about Cyberpunk. I was talking about Cyberpunk last night, actually. Had a couple people over to the house for Labor Day, and I was chatting, you know, like, with someone who was interested in investing in CD Projekt. And they were like, what else are they working on? I'm like, this game that looks super cool. So you want to get in there. You got the log, you got, you know, it's just like, how do I get in there? It's all... There might be plushies of her breed we haven't found yet. Yeah, there's probably, I mean, she's a mini Australian Shepherd, but even if you got an Australian Shepherd, she's still shaped like them. So if you just got a regular Australian Shepherd plushie. So yeah, I'm trying to figure out what to do here. You know, it's interesting. I got like, well, I don't have something sticking out of the S, because that'll look dumb. I don't know, I'm trying to figure out how to make this, like, a little forest area here, because, like, most of the trees that were available to me were dumb, or way too tall. We're not doing flowers, we're doing trees. Even just the general Disney Infinity tree is just, like, gargantuan. Well, yellow aspen fit underneath. Beautiful! There we go. Alright, we can fit underneath there. Nice. Yeah, let's put a couple down. Let's put one, like, way over here. Furthest back corner. Like there, and then like... There. it's too close. Maybe one like right back here. I don't know if you see it. Do you fit? No. Do you fit? Yeah, you fit. Sweet. A bunch of weird trees. Trying to put them back so you don't see them like as easily from the top. That might be a battle I'm gonna lose no matter what, but oh well. Too tall. Oh, these are pretty. Nice. Put these guys next to the big trees over there. You know, then I might not go overboard, because it's like, I mean, like, where are we coming from here? We got the E. No idea what we're going to do with the E. Say you're coming around the side. You know, it's just like, oh, it's a nice little park. Maybe I'll take, like, the garden blocks and bring them over here, or, like, just have a garden floor. Instantly, his company runs out of plushies and doesn't understand why. Like, whoa. Let me just make sure, actually, before I get too proud of myself. Platforming toy? I always forget what, like, the walls are called. Like, the invisible walls. Not called invisible walls, and they're not in the same... They're not in Creative Toys, I think. Eh. I always end up just doing this. And since we're getting close to be having a half an hour left, I'm gonna stop in just a little bit, and then I'm gonna run downstairs, and I'm gonna see what everybody else is up to. The people are making stuff, you know. Actually... That one right there. Oh, I didn't grab that one. Yeah, these are like invisible, right? These can go anywhere. I mean, I know they're invisible, but... It's in platforming toys. Okay, scalable barrier block. I thought it was just there. I didn't see no scalable barrier block. Oh, and you can put it, like, right in the middle there. Oh, that's awesome. Cool. This part. That's too wide, so you gotta grab... Where is it? Oh boy, it's like in the thing. Oh no. This might be virtually impossible to grab. There it is! Sweet. There you go. You just make that a super thin wall. And then you drop out of spark mode. And then you drop out of platforming tools. And then you hope it doesn't crash. And then... Can't get in there. Can't get in there. Hardy har har. But I don't... Want that to, like, no. Turn that off, yeah. No collision effect. So you just, yeah, can't get in. You wish! These trees are just too dense. Well, of course, there's no visible on that side, but... I'll add more. Maybe I'll have a little, like, woodland creatures around here, too.
But again, anything with AI, anything that like moves around, gets dicey. Okay, so let's see what's going on. So we got. Clouds. What's up, cloud? Okay, so we gotta get across. Get across here. And oh no. Okay. That's happening. Oh, don't go there. Really? Don't do this? Okay. What? You just get trapped somewhere? Okay. That was terrifying. So yeah, thanks a lot. Thanks for nothing. That doesn't go up to anything. I like the little zigzag shadow effect. That's cool. What's up, Thorn? Ooh, he's going in here. Oh, things are oh, man. Things are happening in here. Oh, my goodness. Thor's dropping some ice blocks. Oh, my god. Oh, wait. Oh, man. Oh, jeez. Oh, no. Oh, no. Sorry, I broke your blocks. Oh, no. Try to very, like, silently dispatch him. Okay, cool. Oh, and you gotta smash to go around here. Oh, there's more. Oh, there's a gem back there. Oh, no, there's a Yeti with a gem. Oh, it's too good. Okay, I smashed some of those blocks. Sorry. But that was amazing. Cool, I love it. And again, it's we haven't had any of that. And then there's also some cool stuff down here. Yeah, there's, like, this takes you somewhere. Oh, and there's another gem. Okay, so there's... We might be out of gem. We might be at capacity on gems. We'll see. Because we have a little secret hiding areas, and I might make them have something that's not a gem. I might have, you know. I'm gonna figure out where the best locations are gonna be for gems. But like we was doing with the L, it's kind of fun that the L, you know, the L's aren't gonna be super complex, and I like that the letters are getting smaller. Let's go check out the racetrack. Alright, no better way to... Oh, jeez, there's a whole... Whoa, calm down, dude. Oh, jeez, I broke another one. Here, I'll put it back. Oh, no. Broke another one while trying to hit the L button. Select one of these to put it back. Uh-oh. I've done messed everything up. There we go. Oh, how'd I wind up in here? Oh, no. How do you get to here? Whoa. Oh, so you gotta win the race to get that? Okay. Stress, man. It's so funny that I, like, wound up in there. Let me go into spark mode. And go over, like, here. And then exit spark mode. And exit. And then, yeah. There we go. So, yeah. The only thing that's bad about this toy box is... that it is just absolutely friggin' huge. So I wonder. So again, with this, I'm curious to do like the here. Let me try. Oh, so wait. There's a couple blocks on top of these bigger guys. Okay. So I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna see how this looks. From up above. See if it flies. Um.
Let's try that. So, yeah, so I don't know if we actually need... Oh, stop it. Keep hitting the wrong button. I wonder if... No. I don't like it. Cast shadows. I don't like it. But what I don't mind... keep doing that. Yeah, what I don't mind, because again, you just gotta take a block out, and, but, what I don't think is terrible is, if it just drops, because I think that shadow is a lot smaller, and it's gonna be wide on all sides. The further you get away from it, like, the more difficult it is to see. I don't know if I can, like, put a block there and, like, make it invisible or something, like, make you fall through it. Have people just kind of be like, how do you get into the eye? And just kind of run around. But like, for now, I'm fine with that gap there. That's okay. I can live with that. And I like it better kind of being at the top. Because there's like a dot in an eye anyway. And so, what I want to do, which I might have to do offline, because I don't want to mess with the other people playing right now. Although, there is kind of a pleasure in that. So I want you to hop into this guy. So yeah, this guy's right in the middle of the L at the moment. So there's a chance Silent Consonant will fall through the floor. But later when I get a chance, it'd be fun to... Yeah, let's just like gut out the eye first of all. Let's gut it. Oops. Didn't mean to do that, but that's okay. I can't remember where I was at. Oh, we had a wonderful meet and greet. I think I mentioned that briefly before. We had a really nice meet and greet with some very nice allies at PAX this weekend. And I asked, one of the things I like to ask at these meet and greets is, you know, what do you think of what we're doing? Like, could you change something? Do you miss something from, you know, the GT days? Like, you know, here's your chance. Message board, you know, go for it. And one person asked what this is going to become. They're like, thanks, Mike's man. They're like, oh, what are you going to do? Uh-oh, did I lose Silent Consonant? Oh, because I said I was going to drop onto the floor. Yeah, okay. They said, what are you going to do for Toybox Tuesday? What is Tuesday morning going to become? And I don't want to betray the legacy of... the Tuesday Toy Boss experience by replacing it with something like a Dragon Quest Builders or a Dreams or a Lego Dimensions or something else. I had this on Tuesday because Tuesday was a day back in game trailers that Mondays were always rough because it's the beginning of the week. Fridays were always rough because we were finishing the countdown. So it had to be a Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. And I was like, oh, Toy Box Tuesday. Like, it works. I like alliteration, even though it's not 100% alliteration. But I think Tuesday mornings might just become my regular stream. I think it might just be like Brandon's weekly stream. So instead of playing Disney Infinity every week, I'll play whatever.
So I won't, because right now, this week, it's not in the schedule right now, but I really want to do another episode of Brandon Go, which is my mobile series. I want to play Deus Ex Go, and which I haven't played yet, so I want to play it for the very... I played it for like a little bit at E3, but like really dive into my own profile, see how far I can get in that game in 2 hours, or in 1 hour. And I really want to play the last station, the final station. I think it might be called the final station. That is a train side-scrolling pixel-based apocalypse survival shooter game. And it just seems very interesting, so I want to check that out this week. But what I have to do is figure out a time that's not obviously tonight and not a time the other people are streaming, and it's a time that I can still do while still doing all my work and Cup of Jones and everything. Now I'll just be able to do that on a Tuesday. So I'll be like, oh, well, next that Tuesday will be the final station or whatever. No question. I'll do a new game every week. So, but yeah, Brandon's Tuesday roundup. But it's nice, too, because we have the group stream Tuesday night. Right after this, I go get lunch. I do some shopping for Allies supplies throughout the week. I stock the fridge. I go pick up mail. So like, Tuesday's a nice, you know, from top to bottom, like, official, no matter what, you know, Easy Allies work day for me. And it's nice, too, because it's not a Monday or a Friday, so it doesn't get, you know, I don't usually have conflicts with big events and stuff like that happening. But, so yeah, I might leave it at this. I'm not actually sure what to do for the next 28 minutes. I'm gonna go down and, like, mess with the racetrack. Yeah, but I like just, like, whoa, like, dropping in, and then, it'd be fun if, I'm gonna take out the platform and then add squares... so that there's just kind of like a column here, and then you fall through that for a little bit, and then you get to the bottom, and then maybe when you get, you walk over here, there are the little things that shoot you up, and those blast you all the way back up. And you can be go up and out. Maybe don't make it like a lot... like, maybe just, like, double the size. Just, like, you fall for a little bit longer than you're expecting to. And then... yeah, and then Silent looks like it's gonna finish up the L. Was he in the second L right now? He's in the second L! Oh my good, we're getting there, everybody. We just gotta do the E after this. So I kind of have the I figured out. I gotta, like, do some, you know, touches to the Y. Which we have the concept for, but I haven't finished yet. And, yeah, we're just gonna figure out what to do with that E. Maybe keep that E as simple as possible. maybe make the goal of that E to not be super crazy insane. I'm curious what he's doing. What is he doing in here? How do you get into this L? It's right over there. Okay. This is where we pop out. Pop out over here. Okay. How do we get into here? What's going on? Ooh, we're getting... Oh, we get a little underwater. Oh, nice. Okay, I like it. I also think the likelihood to put a gem in, because we can't have a... Nice, I like it. And then you bop out on this side. Whoa, where are we? Whoa. Oh, that's the whole L, huh? Boy, that's a big letter. Cool, yeah, I wasn't expecting that. Fun. Yeah, and we can, like, change it. We can, like, put a thing up so that, like, when you... if you walk through here... all the color changes, so by the time you, like, get into this area, like, you can actually make it very dark and blue, so it looks like you're under the water. We gotta figure out what's in each letter first. But, oh boy, both L's are getting done. Got that eye there, I'm so stoked. It's time to race. Not officially, I'm just gonna get in a car and drive around. But, oh, they're all laid out, they're all ready to go, look at that. Oh, look at that! Oh, that's a pro. Oh, I got a speeder bike loaded up. Here, I don't want to mess with this stuff, so I might just... I might save the race for the end. I don't want to, like, mess with what... that's what he's doing. Yeah, I can't wait to change the backgrounds. We should put the bottom should be lava. This should be the background when you do the race. So when you go through the teleporter and you first show up in this area, it should change the background. And it should change it to the volcano thing. Really excellent choice in racers. This is like... is this a Star Wars thing, I'm assuming? A little Star Wars speeder. We got the Tron car. We have... if you're unfamiliar, this is Tony Stark's Lamborghini, I believe. And a speeder bike. Awesome. So maybe we can just kind of float around and take a look at it. Okay, so we do... We go right into a loop. This is very unforgiving. This is very dangerous. Starting off, and then we're going in, and then the track splits. That's a tough one to get. And then what happens? And then you teleport out of there? So you go driving off, crashing into this area to get this gem. We might be all gemmed out. That's how you get in here. You can't get in there, but that's how you get the key so you can get out. Okay, so I thought you had to get the gem by winning the race, but I guess you don't. So, okay, that's fun. So then we're going around here. Let's just do the race in slow motion. So then another loop. These loops are not easy. I love this game, but right into a turbo thing. Brutal. And then right into another turbo thing. Gotta dodge these guys. And then we go quick right, but we got that wall to hug. We go across a bridge, which I like. I gotta admit, I don't love the pools of ice suspended in midair. I'd kind of want to put some ground there, but I know putting ground in will be excessive on the toy box size. And then we go up, and I don't know if I love the swoopy going ups. I think there's like a more direct way that we can maybe do that. Might tweak that later. Then we go up, and then we turbo boost, and we go hopefully through this ramp. I like the borders here. It's nice. Nice touch. Then we go through a ring of fire, and then... Oh, we actually added a little floating platform for that to be on. Nice. Might change the appearance of that. We go through another loop, because Silent Consonant... Because Bow Rider is... Just loop crazy. But we got the wall on the other side there. That is appreciated. We go around your little inflatable man here. We've got a couple turns. Then we got a zigzag section. And then when we're done with zigzags, we got the finish line. Looks like we're pretty close. Boat Rider's really getting there. Again, Boat Rider, exercise caution. We are running out of space in this thing. We haven't gotten any error messages yet, but when we do, we're done. So if we hit the last letter and we get an error message, then we're like, great. Then we can just kind of trim the fat a little bit around and just make sure. Because again, it's not just about hitting that mark. If you just hit below the mark, performance in this thing is not going to work well. Like it'll have. I mean, that's you can also kind of wear that as a badge of pride, but it'll have like a little warning and be like, this thing will probably not run well. Heads up. Definitely gotta get classic Tron in here. There's no question. No question about that. You go into one of these letters and pop out. Classic Tron. I guess we could do the Y. Why? Because I said I would work on it, and I haven't. Very dark in here, though. So... We get any more lit up area. It's kind of cool that lights this place up a little bit. That would also be really fun too. I never really thought about that. It'd be fun to pick what background is this? Just like the night sky, edge of space, just general combat music with just space background. It'd be cool to drop the bad guys from not Incredibles, from the Toy Story in space map. They're the ones that you fight the very first Disney Infinity. This part didn't save. No, I guess not. Okay, I guess I gotta do this whole interior again. Well, might as well do it now. Like this basically. Like there are enemies that shoot kind of glowing orbs like that, and so if when you walk into this Y, we intentionally make it super dark. It'd be fun if those types of enemies spawn and you can't see the interior, but when they shoot at you, you can, because they'll light it up with all of their Hero of Lime. I beat him to the Y joke. Can we put a purple gem somewhere that doesn't add up like the red gems, but displays a funny message when you collect it? Yes. Yes, we can. I'll turn one of those gems into a purple gem. Probably one of the ones that, because I don't want it to be one of the first ones, so it might be one of the ones that Silent Consonant just put down. We need to delete some stuff here. So what I want to do... This guy... is make a little platforming hell here. Actually, make it easy, but just make it kind of stressful because there's going to be a bunch of enemies below. And so you're trying to jump over. There's just all these enemies everywhere. I don't know where I am. Oh, I'm all turned upside down. Okay. Actually, no. Exit. I kind of like these being the white blocks in here. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Wrong. Why is it when I get inside these places, I'm just like, what am I? Okay, so that's where my character is standing. And I want to jump over there, so I want to make this block there. It's a really good angle right there. I can totally see where I want this to go. Yep, it's a good angle. Go like there. Then hit exit. Yeah. So I want to have to do that. You gotta climb up, and you get out that way. And then take these out. Definitely take you out. Take me out. Take out these blocks. Okay. Then we add them here. And then this is the corner, right? We put one there too, okay? We need purple gems for false gems. It'd be funny if we had multiple false gems. Be cute if, like, there were a lot of different kind of colored gems you could pick up and they would say different funny things. Oof, I believe you're officially in the red. We are in the yellowish red. But yeah, red. This music makes me think of Red Dead. I'm gonna be back on Red Dead Thursday night, 10 p.m. Red Dead Remastered rumors coming in hot and heavy. Yeah, the rumor mill is cranking away. So let me make sure I'm getting this right. Not quite the end. No, because that goes all the way to there, so this should go to there. Yeah. So how does this go? It's like... keeps going to the corner there, okay. So we'll do the same thing. Right? It goes diagonal until it goes up to there. Yeah, okay. So do the same thing here. That one just went right up against the wall there. Okay. Cool. Yeah, cool. So this would be actually a tall block. I actually want a tall block here. Two block. But the rest of these are smaller ones. And you don't have to worry about the little platforming thing down below. You will have to fight enemies. This will be the enemy gauntlet letter. There will be lots of little enemy spawner things, and they will spawn all different types of enemies. And I think there's going to be a rope. Because ropes sound like a, that's like, you know, you go through like military training and I climb up those ropes. I wonder if that is a platforming toy. It sounds like a platforming toy. A rope for you to climb up. Rock hammer pendulum? No. Yeah, ladders. Parallel pipes, long pipe, short flagpole pipe, flagpole pipe pole. Are we at the end? Okay, I guess I'll do a flagpole. It's fine. Oh, flagpole base. Okay, yeah, there we go. Flagpole base. What? That doesn't... Oh, okay. Huh? What? Okay, let's see if I can actually climb up that. So, yeah, this will have a ceiling, and this will be red. But you gotta jump across. Because you gotta jump across here. See? Messed that up. Just gotta get in through here to get into here. To get across here. Which, again, if you're flying, you're cheating. Like I am. Get across here to get through here to drop down there. I wonder if we're doing a transition from like the L's to the L's. I wonder if we should have like a wall here. You can't really see it from above, so I wonder if this is like blocked off. Kind of tempted to do that right now. Just put that in. Blocked off. You gotta do it. Actually, yeah, that's fine. I like that size. I'll just slip you in. You gotta. Can we get into the cell? Oh, right, yeah. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, anyway. Wonder what's going on with the aquarium L. Hold on, I guess I can go the other way. Oh, the little empire flag, a little treasure chest or something over here. Nice. I like it. And I wonder if... Okay, let's do this. Let's go back to platforming. I wonder if there's a fun way... get people up to the top of this. Then maybe they can see, like, right away. Factory conveyor, no. No. No, blink block, no. Yeah, we don't want to get, like, super complex. Masher, no. Jumping block, no. What does that do? Like, throws you up? No. Factory crusher, no. No, no.
can't, like, attach to something like that? Oh, I guess not. It's gotta stand on its own. What? Why does that have like a... Oh, there we go. Long pipe climb. If you can see that from above. Yeah, you probably can. That looks a little gross. Maybe I'll put it in the back. There we go. Somebody just fall down there. Nice. Cool. Silent Continent. Looks like those L's are done. I mean, let's do the racetrack when we're finished. It's 11:53. Let's do the racetrack. Okay, so let's save this puppy. Everybody, come back to the A. Bo Rider, if there's stuff you want to add to the racetrack, you can do that later. I want to race that sucker. The Y is in poor shape right now, but I will finish that up. Actually, here, let me just, for my sanity. Actually, no, because now I don't want to color all of those later. The frame rate's chugging a little bit. Did we lose Bo Rider? No, we got Bo Rider. We've all stayed in, no crashes, nobody got dumped. This worked out actually pretty good. We've all stick to our original characters. What's up, gents? Logo V3. Save. Wow, this one went by real quick. I'm not gonna lie. So we have again. Let's check the calendar. Today's Tuesday the 6th. We got two more. So it looks like all the letters are finished. If I have time, I will do a little more. If not, I will stay up all Monday night next week, putting all sorts of final touches to the toy box so that next Tuesday, the 13th, I'm not going to be out of town or anything crazy. No, I'm going to be around on the 20th as well. Great. No crazy events. So next Thursday, the 13th, will be the final day. Give the L water effect for me if you could. Yeah, and I think we need to change we should change the interior. We should give a water effect around the interior. And I don't know if you heard me, but I was talking when you walk in there, it should change the theme in the background, so it changes the lighting. Because I think that stuff's translucent. I think it lights up. But next week will be the absolute cutoff for adding new things to this toy box. And then the 20th will be just making sure it all works. You know, just kind of adding the final touches. Maybe by the end of the stream on September 20th, I'll actually run through it and just pretend like, hey, okay, so this is it. This is our first, like, official run of the toy box. And we'll just make a bunch of lists, like a big list of notes. And then by the 27th, the 27th is also a Tuesday. The 27th is the last day before that submission date. I would like to have the toy box already submitted by then. So by September 27th, I'd like to submit it maybe by the 23rd, by the end of the week, so that the 30th September, which is that deadline, is a Friday. So that way that if I do it that weekend, they start Monday of that week that ends on the Friday of the submission, and they already have it. And I can reach out to them and be like, what do you need this week? Did we fix it? Did anything go wrong? Maybe some people can just jump into the toy box and check it out. Friends of mine can download it and jump in. But I think the 23rd will be our cutoff the 20th will be the cutoff for any of you to join and add your own creative ideas to the toy box. Personally, the 23rd will be my cutoff for touching it and doing anything to it. You know, the 25th at the absolute latest. And then it'll be in the hands of Disney Interactive and Avalanche Software. Let's race. So the toy box is saved. Let's get down there.
Let's meet up. Mr. Bowrider built this racetrack. I'm calling the speeder bike right now. I'm going to be absolutely terrible in the speeder bike, but... Bowrider, I will let you cue the race. So I don't know if you... can set that up, or if it's set up to do that yet, or if we just ride for fun. Is cutoff confirmed. I'm waiting for him. He looks like he just wants to go anyway. Do we just drive? Is that how we do it? I like how the other car is on the racetrack. We're gonna have to, like, avoid that other car. Are we just going? Okay, I guess we're just going. Already falling off. Already falling off, and I'm off my bike. Race failed, confirmed. Oh, those firework launchers? Nice. Okay, it's back. Alright. Okay, gotta take this race nice and slow. Oh, it's terrible with that car there. Oh, the loops are so bad. Okay, but at least you got walls there, thanks. Okay. Then you immediately go in. I guess it's like by default you get that red gem. Boy, this track, man. Oh no. What is that whistling sound? Yeah, whatever that sound is, I think we might have to get rid of that. Oh no, this is not gonna work. Oh wait! Oh, I did it! No. What? No, get rid of that speed thing there. See, like, I'll, you know, those are little changes I'm gonna make. That speed thing is just instant death. That's not... Oh no. Yeah, what is that? Yeah, Bowrider, is that the... I wonder if it's that guy. Or I wonder if it's the speeder bike. Nope. Wasn't that thing. What on earth is making that sound? Oh, it spawns all of them? Oh, that's cool. Here, there's more cars for you to run into. Here, let me drive this one off. No. Oops. Messed up. Here, get out of here. What? Now it's back. So we might want to rethink the spawning of the cars. Or I guess okay, here we go. I guess we just go this way. What? Oh, here we go. Yeah, what on earth is that whistling sound? Does silent consonant know, as he said? Okay, gotta be careful.
You can't beat me. You only delay the inevitable.
Whoa. Whoa. Oh, I think it's gone. Yeah, whatever that was, kill it with fire. That thing was, that was toxic. Am I going the right, oh no. I wonder if you can, like, fake it. I wonder if, like, this is viable. It's just, like, that move. Oh no! Right in the turbo boost. Also, Bowrider, very key, you know, how do you start the race? How do we actually, like, make this an official, like, race? Whoa. Finish this thing, at least. Ugh, brutal. These speed things are just... not very friendly. Just had a squirrel run across the rooftop, and Sophie about lost her damn mind. Yep, that was a squirrel, Soph. You've heard that sound before. Whoa. Oh, jeez. No.
Stop. No, stop! Ah! Oh, jeez. Alright, I guess I get the gist of this. Are we back? There we go. We did it. We finished. See, I just want to keep. Is that bad? Is that bad when I do that? Is that bad? Is that a bad idea? Should I hit that one more time? So I saved it right before we did this race, so none of this applies. But should I crash this baby? Well, before we crash, thank you, Bowrider, thank you, Silent Consonant, for joining us. I'm assuming they will be back, if not next week, the week following, to put their final touches. I might tweak the racetrack a little bit. I might tweak some of the stuff that Silent Consonant has added this last time, and of course, I will definitely be tweaking this toy box in general before we finally post it. Not enough cars? We need more cars. Okay. It hasn't buckled yet. Disney Infinity, everybody. Disney Infinity. I want to miss the heck out of this game. Okay, that's Toy Box Tuesday. Thank you, Silent Consonant. Just destroy the beauty. Be sure to get rid of that terrible whistling. I think we did. I think the whistling's gone. I'm very curious what that was. That's so great. Seeing Thor just mess things up. So there we are. I'll be back next Tuesday. Tonight is our group stream. I have absolutely no idea what we are playing. But I will get that set up, and we will be back at 6 p.m. Pacific time. That is exactly 6 hours from now, so come back and join us for our group stream. We'll have everybody here. Bloodworth and I missed last week, but we're back. So thank you all for tuning in and watching us build this. We are getting close to the end of Toy Box Tuesday, but it is still going on. And it's still happening, and it's still fun to have all of you participate, whether online, actually in the game playing with me, or just hanging out on Twitch. I hope you all have a lovely Tuesday. I'll see you in a little bit.